In this chapter, we dealt mainly with skeletal muscle and how it contracts. The last part of this chapter will deal with smooth muscle, and we'll point out the differences between smooth muscle contraction and skeletal muscle contraction. So, of course, smooth muscle is found in the walls of our viscera or our hollow organs. They're also found in our blood vessels, in our tracts, like respiratory tract, digestive tract, and the iris, which is the colored part of our eye, is also smooth muscle. Of course, smooth muscle only has one nucleus. It's uninucleate. But smooth muscles do not have sarcomeres. Remember, those are units of contraction in skeletal muscle. There's no myofibrils. There's no T-tubules. And they don't have the same neuromuscular junctions as skeletal muscles. So let's see how smooth muscles work to contract. There are actin and myosin, thin and thick filaments in smooth muscles, but they also have another type of filament, which are intermediate filaments that you see here. Intermediate filaments are joined at these nodes that we call dense bodies. So in actin and myosin, which you don't see here, slide against each other, they're pulling on the intermediate filaments, which causes these dense bodies to move closer together and then farther apart again. And you can see them contracting in this corkscrew type of manner. So dense bodies would be equivalent to the Z-discs in a sarcomere when we're talking about skeletal muscle. In skeletal muscle, we have neuromuscular junctions, where a neuron would come in and synapse with the muscle fiber. In smooth muscle, we don't have these neuromuscular junctions, but we typically have diffuse junctions. So you see the neuron, but instead of seeing the axon terminal, we see all these varicosities, which are bulges in the axon, which stimulate the smooth muscle. So instead of a very specific synapse, like there is in a neuromuscular junction, we have all these varicosities generally over the smooth muscle tissue. So they release their neurotransmitters across this entire area of smooth muscle very diffusely instead of very specific. So we have diffuse junctions instead of neuromuscular junctions. There's varicosities instead of axon terminals. In skeletal muscle, the calcium is stored in the sarcoplasmic reticulum and is released when the action potential travels down the T-tubules. And recall that calcium then binds to troponin. Tropomyosin moves out of the way so that a cross bridge can be formed between actin and myosin. In smooth muscle, it's a little different. There is still calcium stored in the sarcoplasmic reticulum, just like in skeletal muscle, but that's not where most of the calcium comes from. Most of the calcium comes from outside the cell that enters inside. Where it's located outside the cells are in these little pouches that exist on the outside. We call those calveoli, which are little caves. So when the smooth muscle is stimulated, the calcium will enter the cell from the calveoli like we see here. Instead of binding to troponin, smooth muscle does not have troponin. It binds to a protein called calmodulin instead. And then a whole series of reactions take place, which you don't really have to memorize all these middle players here, like MLCK. But the end result is that the myosin head is activated. So there's no troponin, tropomyosin, there's no contact inhibition here. It's just a myosin head that gets activated from calcium rushing in from the calveoli, binding to calmodulin. Series of reaction activates the myosin head to form the cross bridge and produce the power stroke. There are two types of smooth muscle tissue contraction. The first one involves the smooth muscle in our organs, in our hollow organs or visceral organs. Of course, not the heart. The heart has cardiac muscle, its own type. We have these varicosities like we've seen. This diffuse junction is spread over top of this tissue. So these cells here that are in close contact with the varicosities will be stimulated by the neurotransmitter. But what about these cells that are deeper in the tissue? Well, when these superficial cells get stimulated, you see gap junctions that join cells to other smooth muscle cells, so that stimulation will travel from one cell to another through these gap junctions. This is called single unit smooth muscle because we just need this single unit of neurotransmitters being released, and from that single unit, all these layers of smooth muscle cells will be stimulated because of the gap junctions. In multi-unit smooth muscle, we see this diffuse junction actually enter deep into the smooth muscle tissue because there are no gap junctions. Since there are no gap junctions, the signal can't spread from one cell to another, so all the cells in this smooth muscle have to be in contact or close contact with these diffuse junctions. This does not happen in our organs, but in the smooth muscle in our blood vessels, and some of our tracts, and the iris of our eye.